Hi, and welcome back to Lesson 8, Level 3, where we explore the art of using data tables in order to create advanced simulations. We've recently learned how to use one variable and two variable data tables, as well as Scenario Manager. These are ideal for determining the interaction of a number of variables. However, if we want to have Excel help us to determine the likely outcome of a situation, this depends upon your knowledge of your company's business and the market that you're in. To aid us in predicting the future, we can use a two-variable data table to produce simulated results that show how probable each result is. Simulated results are those that are based on realistic but not actual data. Businesses often work with simulated likely data and results where they are either starting a new operation, expanding into a new market, or dealing with any other situation in which no real data is available. Instead of using historical or current data, you can instead use probable data in data tables and then produce simulated results. Some of the Excel functions that we previously learned about, such as the random number generators, VLOOKUP, and two variable data tables, can also be used together and weight simulated results in order to accurately determine the probability of different results. The next three videos demonstrate how to use them in conjunction with each other in order to help us predict the likely outcome for a new business venture. Now that we know what it can do for us and why we'd want to do it, let's get to work on actually applying it to a new venture within TZ Edge. To begin this lesson, we'll try to analyze the sales pricing options for a new TZ Swim Skin product, and we want to analyze the sales price options for this new product based upon the probabilities that the demand for the product will range from some high value to some low value. What we have here in our probabilities worksheet is a list of assumptions with our sales number actually left out. If we put in a value that we think might correspond to the number of units that we're going to sell, all of the functions in these other projection cells will work, and they then tell us the resulting marginal pre-tax income. However, comma, while me just putting numbers in here will give us our pre-tax income, it's really cool and informative. What's the actual number that I need to put in here so that I can get a firmer prediction of what I actually expect over here? Since I don't have a crystal ball and I don't know the actual value, I'll just have to find a probable value. How do I do that, you ask? The probable value for the sales will come from this lookup table down here and will be determined as part of a simulation using what's called in the financial world as a cumulative probability distribution. In financial statistics, a probability distribution assigns a probability to every interval of numbers. Looking down here at this awesome table, we have a list of the units that we expect to sell as well as the probability of us selling each of those amounts. Our high-caliber marketing department has determined these probabilities for us, and they're confident that there is a 25% probability of us selling at least 1,000 units. They think there's a 40% chance of us selling 2,000 units, 20% for 3,000, 10% for 4,000, and a slim 5% chance of us selling at least 5,000 units. Part of this simulation involves us using a VLOOKUP function to randomly tell us how many units we're going to sell. This randomly generated unit sales amount will then be placed up here into cell C9, and for each randomly generated sales amount, we'll then automatically record the resulting pre-tax income here in H19. Unfortunately, our marketing department hasn't had this class, so they don't realize that a VLOOKUP function needs to look up values in the left-hand column and then returns the value in the columns to the right. Here we have the units sold in this first column and probabilities in the second column. The way that we're going to get this to work is to generate a random number between 0 and 1, compare it to these percentages, and then have that determine which of these five values to jam up here into C9. So first off, these columns are in the wrong order. We could just move these columns around like this, but that doesn't completely solve our problem, as we undoubtedly remember that our lookup values must be in the ascending order. So let me undo this. Control Z, Control Z, Control Z. And over here to the right, let me just show you the proper way to do all this. In order to properly handle this, we're going to have to convert these pairs of numbers into what is referred to as the cumulative probability distribution table. In this table, we still have the related units now correctly located to the right of the corresponding cumulative probability here in the first column of this lookup data. That means that any randomly generated number that comes in between this value of 0 and this value of 25% yields a unit sold of 1,000. Anything between 25 and 65% will render a value of 2,000. Between 65 and 85, we get 3,000. Between 85 and 95, we get 4,000. And anything between 95 and 100%, or in this case, anything over 95%, we'll get a unit sold amount of 5,000. Let me show you the formulas behind us getting from these individual probabilities over here that those poor folks that haven't had this class before provided us into this properly formatted cumulative probability distribution table that we can make sing. To begin with, we just put a 0 in this top left cell. The next cumulative probability down is just the individual probability added to the previous value in this cell immediately above it. So this will be 25% plus 0, or 25%. The next cell down will be the previous value of 25% added to the next individual probability here of 40%, which correctly gives us a 65% here. The pattern continues on down to give us the next values of 85 and 95%. Another way of looking at this or stating it is that there is a 95% probability of the zone selling fewer than 5,000 units. There's an 85% chance of them selling fewer than 4,000 units, and on up here to the first row where there's a 0% probability of them selling less than 1,000 units. The reason for this is that the individual probabilities over here add up to 100%. Therefore, there is no probability that they will sell fewer than 1,000 units. That's why we have a cumulative probability of 0, in essence guaranteeing us that we'll sell at least 1,000 units here. The whole reason we had to reorganize our table from this style to this one is so that we can utilize our awesome VLOOKUP function from Chapter 5 in this simulation. So let's move on towards that goal. Now, I've been mentioning for several minutes that we're going to randomly generate stuff. So let's tie in that piece now. Somewhere on our page, let's create a random number generator that gives us values between 0 and 1. Remembering back to Lesson 2, that would be the rand function. Let's label this cell here to random number. And then in the adjoining cell, let's put in our equals rand, parentheses, parentheses, and there you go. I don't have to do this, but just so that it makes a bit more sense consistency-wise, let me format that as a percentage with an extra decimal place or two. The next step will be to take this random percentage, come over here into our awe-inspiring cumulative probability distribution table, and find the right spot in the first column, and then bring back the corresponding value from the second column. Let's go up to D9, which is our sales in units cell, and type in our formula. Equals VLOOKUP, our randomly generated percentage, comma, our lookup table, column 2, and then we need an approximate lookup, so that would be true because our RAND formula is not going to gracious supply with just values of 0, 25, 65%, etc. It's going to give us every possible decimal value between 0 and 1 here, so I have to have the approximate values. Hit enter and voila! When I hit enter, I'll get a newly generated random number. Here we have 32%. That value is between this 25 and 65, so then that brings us back a value of 2,000 up here. Let me hit the F9 function key and we'll get a different number here. And now we can verify that yes, this 95.92% is greater than this 95%, so we get the corresponding 5,000 units up here in our unit sold cell. Every time any calculation happens on this page, we get a new different random number, so we get a newly generated unit sold value as well. We've now effectively modeled the projected sales of units according to this cumulative probability distribution table derived from the good folks that haven't taken this class that gave us a list of these probabilities here. Think I'm an Excel snob? I know I am, but I'm okay with it. See you in the next video.